Campus late, like after.
Clean insurance.
Oh, it's okay. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Just present in front of the classroom. You'll be okay. I'm just scared of Professor Rosenthal's judgmental gaze at me. I'm only kidding, Professor. I'm in character. How are you? I need you to answer the question. How are you? Good? Okay.
Dave, why are you so nervous about presenting in an empty room?
I'm worried because you're sitting right where I normally sit, watching myself. Right now, I'm watching myself tell the story of my life in front of the class. I'm worried that the dudes in the classroom are going to be thinking I'm not funny. By the way, guys, you're breathing with your mouths open like this, like Neanderthals. Sit up, pay attention, please. Disrespect. I'm also worried that I'm not coming across as the charming, debonair, attractive guy I am to the beautiful girls in this classroom.
You're not. You're not, Dave.
Thanks, Laura. I knew I could count on you. Anyway, on February 10th, 1994, a god was born. I'm just kidding. It's me. I grew up a happy child. I was loved by my parents and grandparents. Growing up, though, was hardest for me with making friends. Me not having friends. That's a total shocker, I mean, come on. Or overcoming my learning disability. I had to be tested to see if I had Asperger's, but I didn't. I just learned I learned a lot slower than other kids. One thing that helped me find myself was my love for movies. Movies was the joy in my life. This is the truth. I have over 3,000 movies in my house. It's not a joke. So growing up, when I really didn't have my friends to go outside and play, I found a love for movies and television and comedy. Like Seinfeld was one of my favorite shows I could watch. It brought such a joy to me. Comedy, like comedians like Chappelle, Chris Rock, people like that. They just always had to put a smile on my face. And my favorite movies are like Pulp Fiction, Goodfellas, like that. It made me want to enter communications as a field because I just have such a great love for movies. That helped me find my inner peace. And plus, while finding my inner peace with myself with that, it helped me find my lifelong friends and helped me overcome who I am. I still have such a love for movies that I applied for a communications degree in college, like I said. While I was in community college, my parents split up, and I was very emotionally hurt over that. Right here, we were such a happy family, but I had to take a year off of college because while I was in community college, but what helped me overcome that was that they helped me make sure that we were always going to be a family and that they would always love each other, but they just worked out better as friends. And they're still good friends, but that helped me overcome worrying if half my parents were going to hate each other or how my life was going to change. It really didn't, and I was able to overcome that. Then, here we are. 2 years later, I left community college. I'm here at Stockton University. I'm now a senior. I worked at the internship for the last semester, community TV internship, where I really didn't know much how to work in a TV studio or anything like that. And working with Mike over next door, he really helped me figure out my way to work in a TV studio, how to work with people as a team. And you have to learn how to interact with others. Like I said, I have a learning disability where I communicate differently from others, but I had to step out of my comfort zone. I'm working with talents such as Bert Lopez or Joe Molino. You have to learn how to interact with your bosses. You can't be shy or stiff. You know, you have to be affable and approachable, and you learn how to balance. And like I said, you learn to work as a team. You learn how to work as a technical director in there. You learn a lot. So not only do I want to apply myself as a writer, will apply myself with possibly what I learned in my internship where I get a job. Now, where can I see myself living? Probably New York City. Manhattan, preferably. I think it goes back to my love with movies and TV, because, like I said, I love Seinfeld. Goodfellas is the film that's filmed in New York. I'm a big fan of Woody Allen films. I just love New York City so much. I think it's just the greatest. Like you said, it is the greatest city in the world, and it's. I love the culture there. You have all these different cultures, religions, background. And everything just comes together in a nice way. That's why I can see myself living in New York. And once I graduate in May, I'm applying for a job in New York, and hope I'm going to try to apply with The Late Show with Stephen Colbert, because my uncle works for the show. He's a sound mixer. Harvey's a nice guy. And it would just make sense, because it goes back to my love with TV and comedy, like I said, Seinfeld. By the way, like I was in high school, I learned to love late-night talk shows like David Letterman, Stephen Colbert, when he had the Colbert Report. I was so fascinated with the movies, television, and comedy. It's probably kept me a virgin throughout my whole high school life. And then, hopefully, if I get a job at the Colbert Show, where do I see myself 5 to 10 years from now? If I really like that job, hopefully working as a comedy writer or possibly something in the TV studio that he has or behind the scenes, I would like to keep that job, but it would have to go back to my love with film. I really would love to write and direct my own films one day, so hopefully in 5 to 10 years, I'm able to accomplish that dream.
And be able to reach for the stars. And hopefully I also find myself, after I accomplish all that, I'm married with kids. Definitely not marriage, I'm single, I'm enjoying the life, I'm slaying right now. I'm kidding, I'm really desperate. Please marry me. I'm just kidding. I'm trying to make everyone in the classroom laugh, and I can see by all your faces right now, I clearly have not done that. This was the story of my life, so I hope you all enjoyed it. So please, tell me, what did you all think of the story of my life?
You're gonna get an A for this.
Turn it off, this is horrible. I'm leaving.